an old woman remembers. Her eyes were gentle. Her voice was for soft singing in the stiff-backed pew or on the porch when evening comes slowly over Atlanta. But she remembered. She said, after they cleaned out the saloons and the dives, the drunks and the loafers, they thought they had better clean out the rest of us. And it was awful. They snatched men off of streetcars, beat up women. Some of our men fought back and killed too. Still, it wasn't their habit. And then the orders came for the militia, and the mob went home and dressed up in their soldiers' uniforms and rushed back shooting just as wild as ever. Some leaders told us to keep faith in the law, in the governor. Some did not keep that faith. Some never had it. He was white too, and the time was near election, and the rebs were mad. He wasn't stopping hornets with his head bare. The white folks at the big houses, some of them kept all their servants home under protection. But that was all the trouble they could stand. And some were put out when their cooks and yard boys were thrown from cars and beaten and came late. Or not at all. And the police, they helped the mob. And the militia, they helped the police. And it got worse and worse. They broke into groceries, drug stores, barbershops. It made no difference whether white or black. They beat a lame boot black until he died. They cut an old man open with jackknives. The newspapers named us black brutes and mad dogs. So they used a gun butt on the president of our seminary, where a lot of folks had set up praying prayers the whole night through. And then, she said, our folks got sick and tired of being chased and beaten and shot down. All of a sudden, one day, they all got sick and tired. The servants, they put down their mops and pans and brooms and hoes and rakes and coachman whips. Bad niggers stopped drinking Dago Red. Good Negroes figured they had prayed enough. All came back home. They had been too long away. A lot of visitors had been looking for them. They sat on their front stoops and in their yards, not talking much, but ready. Their welcome ready. Their shotguns oiled and loaded on their knees. And then there wasn't any riot anymore.